Yes. So this is my 47th video on reanalysis in the playlist of UPSC Max Optional. So far what we are doing is we have been solving in the all previous question papers on reanalysis from 2018 to 1992. So in that way we have finished from 2018 to 2007. Now we are in 2006, right? So in 2006 we have already solved the first two problems. That is, the first problem is examine the convergence of the integral, and the second problem is the a problem based on Dirichlet function, right? So I'm not going to do third problem. Third problem is very standard problem. We have solved many problems in this type. We just need to show this function is continuous and possesses a partial derivative fx 0,0 and fy 0,0. So I think we have solved similar problem. I think we have solved more than 5 to 6 problems in this problem. So in real 2007 also, I think we have solved one problem based on this. Yeah. So you can also refer this video to show that fx and fy exist at 0,0. The only thing is here the function is xy by x square plus 2y square. Now here the function is x cube plus 2y square by x square plus y square, right? You just have to use the same method here. And if you haven't watched the previous video, you please watch from part 1 to part 47. If you watch in between, I'm sure that it is difficult for you to follow, right? So if you are watching from part 1, you can do this sum in a 2 or 3 minutes, right? So now we'll move on to the fourth problem now. So both problems are very interesting problem, and this problem is based on Lagrange's theorem, right? So we have already again we have solved one problem based on Lagrange, many problems based on Lagrange's theorem, and there are the first 25 videos on calculus. I have a separate playlist, and in that playlist I have explained all the concepts, right? So this playlist I have been solving the previous question papers. I have already one playlist for calculus which I explain all theories. So in that playlist you can see the explanation, detailed explanation of and geometrical interpretation of Lagrange theorem, Lotz theorem, etc. So you can also refer that playlist also. Yeah, using Lagrange theorem, prove that cos b minus cos a is less than angle b minus. This question you have solved in 2007. I have stated Lagrange theorem here, right? So what I will do is I'll just copy the Lagrange theorem here. So what Lagrange theorem says is that if a function f defined on closed interval a comma b is continuous on that interval, differentiable on that interval, then there exists a real number c in this interval such that f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus a. So if you want geometric interpretation, you just go through the description in the video. I already explained several times about the geometric interpretation of Lagrange theorem, right? That is the slope of a secant line. There exists at least one point whose slope of that point is parallel to the slope of a secant line, right? Yeah, so you can refer that video also. So now we'll get on to our problem now. So I'm going to prove this with the help of Lagrange mean value theorem, right? Yeah. So first I'll quote Lagrange mean value theorem. So as you already know, Lagrange's mean value theorem. If you can refer this also. If a function f defined on, yeah. If a function defined on closed interval a comma b satisfies, that is, this function is continuous on closed interval a comma b, and it is differentiable on open interval a comma b, then there exists a real number c in between a and b such that f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a by b minus c. This is what Lagrange mean value theorem, right? Yeah, so I'm going to prove this theorem with the help of Lagrange's mean value theorem. It's a very important theorem. A twice differentiable function f, that means this f is differentiable twice. So it is given that this f is differentiable twice, that means f dash exists and f double dash also exists, right? F dash exists, f double dash also exists. A twice differentiable function f on closed interval a comma b is such that, and this function f of a and f of b are both equal to 0, and So what so far this theorem is that this function is defined on closed interval a comma b, and f dash exists, f double dash also exists, and the function value is 0, right? The function value is 0. So let us say something like this, and this also 0. That is, f of a is equal to 0, f of b is also equal to 0. Now for some c, and it is given that if a is less than c is less than b, f of c, the image is greater than 0. That means the image will be somewhere around here. Surely it will be, it is given that it is greater than 0. So that means from here it has been increasing function, right? Yeah. And it is given that f of c is greater than 0 for a less than c less than b, right? This is the information we have given, that f of a is equal to 0, and this is f of b is equal to 0, and this is f of c, and this is greater than 0, right? This is our f of c. We have to prove that there exists one value theta between a comma b, between a and b, such that for which f double dash of theta is less than 0. So we have to prove there exists at least one theta in between this interval whose second derivative is strictly less than 0. That is what we have to prove, right? So we'll get on to the proof. So a little bit tricky proof, but if you listen this carefully, you will understand this. So it is given that f is twice differentiable. It is given, right? It is given. That means f dash, this implies f dash and f double dash exist on closed interval a comma b, right? That means f dash and f double dash exist on closed interval a comma b. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to split this into two interval. The first interval is a to c, and second interval is c to b, right? So our first interval is, yeah, so case 1. Now it is, since a less than c less than b, right? So in this function I'm going to apply Lagrange theorem to f, and you can see our f is twice differentiable, right? So f is twice differentiable. That means f is differentiable on open interval a comma b. If it is differentiable, surely it will be continuous, right? Differentiability implies continuous, but continuity does not imply differentiability, right? Yeah. So that means in this interval our f satisfies the Lagrange mean value theorem, right? So in this interval, so since a less than c less than b, I'm splitting only to on the first interval, right? A comma c. So on the closed interval a comma c, on the closed interval a comma c, f is twice differentiable. So that means in this interval our Lagrange theorem, in this interval the first two hypotheses of Lagrange theorem satisfies. That means in this interval there exists at least one real number c. So we don't need to write c here, because already used c here. This is nothing but a representation, right? It's symbol. So there is at least one real number. Let us say that real number to be theta 1. There exists at least one real number theta 1 such that f dash of theta 1 is equal to f of c minus f of a by c minus a, right? So that means our condition 1 and 2 of Lagrange's theorem are satisfied. Right, that means these two are satisfied, 1 and 2. So there exists a real number theta 1 in this interval a comma c such that f dash of theta 1 is equal to f of c minus f of a by c minus a, right? I'm just applying the Lagrange theorem to this interval, right? Yeah. Though this theta 1 is between where? A and c. There is some theta 1 whose derivative will be parallel to the secant line, if you want, right? So now we'll apply, now for this interval again, so case 2, so this, I mark this equation as 1, right? Yeah. So on closed interval c comma b, right, again our function is twice differentiable on whole interval, that means here also it is twice differentiable, right? So again f is twice differentiable. This implies f is, let us, what this means, let us read this a comma c, right? A comma c. First we restrict ourselves to this interval. Now here it is differentiable on c comma b. So since this is differentiable, it is also continuous. So f is continuous on closed interval c comma b. So again, the first two statement hypothesis of Lagrange theorem satisfies. So there exist, so by Lagrange mean value theorem, there exists theta 2 in between c and b such that f dash of theta 2 is equal to f of b minus f of c divided by b minus c, right? So our theta 2 lies between c less than theta 2 less than b, right? So there exists theta 2 whose derivative is parallel to the secant line, that is f of b minus f of c divided by b minus c. So I mark this as equation number 2, right? Yeah. Now it is given that our f of a and f of b are equal to 0, right? So it is given that our f of a and f of b are equal to 0. So therefore our 1 becomes, since 0, this will be equal to 0, right? Applying our 1 and 2 becomes f of a is equal to 0, f of b is equal to 0. So if I apply that, our 1 will be changed to f dash of theta 1 is equal to f of c divided by c minus a, right? And what will be our 2 changed to? Our 2 changed to f dash of theta 2 is equal to, since f of b is also 0, we will have minus f of c divided by b minus c, right? So where this, I can combine both the 1 and 2, a less than theta 1, theta 1 less than c, c is less than theta 2, and this is less than b, right? So you can refer the diagram, a less than theta 1, theta 1 less than c, theta less than theta, c less than theta 2, and this is less than b. So far what I did is, I have just applied Lagrange theorem to this interval, and I have used the condition that f of a is equal to f of b is equal to 0. That is what I have proved now, right? Yeah. Now, it is given that f is twice differentiable, that is f dash exists and f double dash also exists, right? So what we did is, we applied Lagrange mean value theorem to f and we obtained this two inequality, right? So we applied Lagrange theorem to f to obtain this inequality. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to apply Lagrange theorem to f dash, right? I can apply f dash, because why? Because f double dash exists. So we can apply Lagrange theorem to f if this f dash is continuous and differentiable, right? Now I can apply Lagrange theorem to f dash because our f double dash is also differentiable, because it is given that f is twice differentiable, right? So again, f dash is continuous and differentiable on, I'm going to restrict the interval only to this theta 1 and theta 2. Why? I'm going to only restrict our case only to this interval theta 1 and theta 2, right? Yeah. I'm going to consider only this interval. So again, f dash is continuous and differentiable on, and theta 1 on this interval theta 1 comma theta 2. So again, I can apply Lagrange mean value theorem, right? So remember, this f dash is continuous, right? So by Lagrange mean value theorem, there exists a real number theta in between theta 1 and theta 2 such that this will be f double dash, right? This will be f double dash. If it is f, it will be f dash. But here you will have f dash. So, will be f dash of theta is equal to f dash of theta 2 minus f dash of theta 1 divided by theta 2 minus theta 1. Remember, if you are applying Lagrange minimal theorem to f, this will be f dash. Here it will be f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. But what we are doing, we are applying to f dash. So this will be f double dash and this will be f dash of b minus f dash of a divided by b minus a. Remember, we are applying Lagrange theorem to not to f, we are applying to f dash. So that's why that this derivative, so this derivative will be f double dash, right? Will be equal to f dash of theta 2 minus f dash of theta 1 by theta 2 minus theta 1, right? Yeah. So, we have f double dash of theta 2, f plus, I can take 1 by theta 2 minus theta 1 outside, and this theta lies between where? This theta lies between here, right? So, theta 1 less than theta 2. So, this will be f dash of theta 2 we already know, right? So, this is f dash of theta 2, this is, I'll mark this as to be equation 3 and this is 4. Now, I'm going to substitute f dash of theta 2 to be minus f of c divided by b minus c minus our f dash of theta 1 by 3 is f of c divided by c minus a, right, c minus a. Now, I can take minus f dash of c outside. So, if I take minus f dash of c outside, so minus f dash of c outside. So, will be theta 2 minus theta 1. This will be, I've taken minus, right? So, this will be 1 by b minus c, 1 by b minus c plus 1 by c minus a. So, if I make LCM here, this will be f dash of c divided by theta 2 minus theta 1. And this will be, if I take LCM here, I have to multiply here by c minus a, I have to multiply here by b minus c. So, or else I'll just take cross multiplication, it will be c minus a plus b minus c divided by b minus c into c minus a. Right? Yeah. Now, I can, this c and this c will get cancelled. So, we have minus f dash of c divided by theta 2 minus theta 1 into b minus a divided by b minus c into c minus a. B minus c into c minus a. Now, we know that since a is less than theta 1 and theta 1 less than c and c is less than theta 2 is less than b, right? Yeah. And we also know that our f of c is greater than 0, right? So, this is from the diagram. And this is given that f of c is greater than 0. So, you can see here, it is given that our f of c is greater than 0 for a less than c less than b. So, therefore, f of c is greater than 0. So, what can I conclude about this value? What can I conclude about this value, right? So, what will be theta 2 minus theta 1, it will be positive or negative, right? You can see here, this is theta, right? This is not theta 2, this is theta, right? F dash of theta. Now, we just examine what we need to prove. We need to prove that f double dash of theta is less than 0, right? So, we need to show that this whole value will be less than 0. That is what we need to prove, right? So, surely it will be less than 0. Why? You can see, our f of c is greater than 0, right? So, I can write this whole term to be minus of f dash of c divided by theta 2 minus theta 1 into b minus a divided by b minus c, c minus a, right? Now, what first will verify one of the, what about this value? This value will always be greater than 0. Why? Because our f of c is greater than 0, that means the derivative is also greater than 0. So, this value will be positive. What will be my theta 2 minus theta 1? You can see theta 2 is theta 1. When you compare theta 1 and theta 2, theta 1 is less than theta 2, right? That is, when you subtract theta 2 minus theta 1, it will be always be greater than 0, right? It will be greater than 0. And again, this will be greater than 0. Why? Because our f of c is greater than 0. And again, b minus a will be, b minus a will be positive. B minus c, again it will be positive. C minus a, it will be positive. You can see that this whole term will be greater than 0. And since you are negative here, this will always be less than 0. So therefore, our f double dash of theta is less than 0. Where this theta lies between a and b. That's it. That is what we need to prove, right? So if f is twice differentiable and f of, and such that f of a and f of b are both equal to 0 and f of c is greater than 0, for a less than c less than b, prove that there exists at least one value of theta between a and b such that the second derivative is less than 0. So that's it, we have proved, right? So what we have proved is, first we have split the interval. I have applied Lagrange mean value theorem to this interval and then to this interval, and then I have used this condition, f of a is equal to f of b is equal to 0. Now I obtained equation 3 and 4. Now I applied the Lagrange mean value theorem to f dash on this interval, theta 1 and theta 2, and then we have proved the result. That's it. It is very simple, right? So, step 1 is applying the Lagrange mean value theorem to A and C. This is step 2. And step 3 will be apply f of A is equal to 0, f of B is equal to 0 on both the steps. So, we will have step 3 is over, and step 4 will step 4 will be applying Lagrange mean value theorem to F dash. Remember, F dash on theta 1 and theta 2, you will have the result, right? So that's it. So I think we have finished 2006 question paper. The next question paper, we'll move on to the next video, we'll move on to 2005 question paper, right? So that's it. We'll see you next video. Goodbye. Thank you.